When ARBEST was created 10 years ago, we knew it had the potential to improve mental health treatment for children and families who had experienced trauma, but we had no idea just how transformative the program could be for our state.
You know, when I think back about the founding of Arkansas ARBEST, it was so important to have a legislative champion like Senator Percy Malone to establish the appropriation and then to make that a permanent function of state government. It was indispensable. Similarly, without our perhaps back then greatest advocate, Donna Malone, it would have been unlikely that this would have ever come to fruition.
We started a legislative task force on neglected and abused children, and they pointed the way to use children's advocacy centers. I talked to experts across the United States, and when it came right down to it, when I asked what we need to help these children who've been abused, they said better training and best practices. And we had to have some form of training that we knew was evidence-based so that the children, we would know that there was going to be a positive outcome and not just a feel-good thing.
I didn't really have the vision that Senator Percy Malone and Donna Malone had. They were the ones that originally came up with this idea of developing a program that would span all of the child advocacy centers. And when I started to kind of formulate what that might look like, the most important thing seemed to me how we would provide mental health services for those children across the state.
Before the ARBEST program, clinicians still had the heart and they knew that they wanted to help these kids, but they were at a loss for tools that they knew could make a strong impact. And so ARBEST's mission has been to equip people with the tools that we know work all across our state, so kids don't have to journey to certain pockets of our state in order to get the best care possible. They can get that right in their hometown from a clinician who understands their home, understands their values, and is equipped with the treatments that work.
It is pretty amazing to see how ARBEST has contributed to each and every one of our centers in a personal and unique way, so that kids in rural areas and urban areas throughout Arkansas can receive excellent mental health services. For a child to come in with just a terrible story to share and a terrible experience that they have gone through, but the hope and healing comes through the therapy part. They don't have to carry the shame and the guilt and just that heavy burden around the rest of their lives, but they're able to break free from that and to move on and have that healing. And it's amazing. It's amazing. We could not do what we do on the mental health side without the support of ARBEST.
The mental health professionals that are in the CACs are really able to provide quality, evidence-based treatment. And the other part of it that I think we've been able to do is really convince people that this treatment works.
You know, for years we were doing all that we knew what to do, and so we did a lot of the components that we use in TF-CBT, but the process was longer. We saw kids get better, but it took such a longer time. And with TF-CBT and the structure and the way that it goes, the healing process is not just for the child, but for the whole family, and we see them all get better in a much shorter time.
One thing that was really big for me in training in evidence-based models is that it really helped increase my competence, which in turn increased my confidence, and that increased hopefulness.
My master's program had really done a good job training me in terms of person in the environment and advocacy. What I wasn't prepared for were the high rates of trauma that I was seeing in my clinic. And so I was a little bit at a loss. I felt like I needed a life raft, sort of drowning in that sea of trauma. A coworker of mine at the time told me about this training that was being hosted with this thing called ARBEST through UAMS, and I felt like someone had finally thrown me that life raft. I had an idea of what to do. It's been such a privilege to get to be that person that sends that life raft out to the clinicians in the state when they're a little bit at a loss and feeling like they're drowning in that sea of trauma.
I'm most proud of the extensiveness of the ARBEST program. We made a very conscious decision not to just offer training to the child advocacy centers, but to therapists throughout the state. And we made a decision that it needed to be from 0 to 4 age group all the way up now into adulthood. Because we know trauma extends the lifespan, and you see effects of it no matter what age of the child. And if we can really intervene early, hopefully later on, you won't have problems in adulthood, but if there are, I want to make sure that there are treatments to address those needs as well.
The thing I'm most proud of is our ability to form relationships and understand the needs of clinicians all across our state. People who work in really rural areas of our state don't necessarily have the same needs and the same resources as clinicians who work in more urban settings, like right here in Little Rock. And so what ARBEST has tried to do and will continue to try to do over the next 10 years is reach every single community. Right now we have clinicians trained in 66 out of the 75 counties in Arkansas. I want it to be 75. I want to make sure that no matter where kids live, they can access the best quality care. And I think ARBEST has hugely changed the landscape so far on how children and families access the services they need.
I see the next frontier for ARBEST really being about transforming our state to deliver trauma-informed care services across all systems. We've begun making inroads. We've begun learning about effective models of transforming organizations, transforming schools, transforming treatment programs. But we have a lot to do. We have a lot of work to do. So I think that arming every person that comes into contact with a child who's experienced trauma, every teacher, every caseworker, every helping professional, the bus driver, everybody who comes into contact with children needs to know how to support their resilience and how to support them in the recovery of a difficult event. I think that the real key to the success of ARBEST in making system changes in our state is really all about partnerships. Without our partners, our work would be pointless. So our child advocacy centers and the association that supports them, our mental health partners all over the state, our university partners, the Commission on Child Abuse, Rape, and Domestic Violence, so many more, child welfare system, Division of Behavioral Health at DHS, they either shape the work that we do and guide us to make sure we get it right, or they're the very people on the front line serving children and families and saying to us, we want to be equipped with the very best techniques for working with these families. We want to know the evidence-based treatment. We want to be trained in the techniques for trauma-informed care.
The bottom line is that because of our work with partners all over the state, children and families are recovering from trauma, and kids are able to get back to the business of being kids.